Kia ora, nau mai, hoki mai, welcome back. Now picture this, Haido, because I can see you all over this. You pop into your local sandwich bar to pick up a quick fizzy drink.
A little Danish.
Yeah, you don't pay much attention to the parking sign because you are going to be ever so quick.
What you don't expect, of course, is a whopping parking bill which climbs as you fight to sort it out. Garth with a story that so many of us can relate to.
At the sandwich factory on Auckland's North Shore, you can still get a munch, for not much.
$4.
$4 for a sausage roll.
Yeah.
How much for a Coke Zero?
Small can, $2.50.
But it's outside that the cost of living really bites.
$340 for 25 seconds of parking. Wow.
This is a heap of money now for me.
After a hard day rigging scaffold, Emerson stopped off here. If you're looking straight ahead or to the right to the lunch bar, you might miss this sign on the left. Big mistake. No parking. Not in this spot anyway.
He told this one I need to pay like $95 for breaching notice.
The sign doesn't say, but Emerson had 3 weeks to pay. That was in a letter a week later. By then, he was back in the Philippines for a month to move his wife and son here after years apart.
It's pretty hard, sir.
It's come at a hard time.
Yeah.
You're overseas,
yeah.
So you don't know that you've been fined 95, and then you get another notice here.
Yeah.
Says you now pay 170.
170 now.
And now it's gone up to 245.
245.
All in less than 6 weeks. Forget that I called it a fine. Emerson paid that breach fee when he got back. But he questioned the reminder charges that still kept coming, even after he'd paid the $95.
So when you write to them, do they write back to you?
I never receive a reply coming from this email.
This is not about fines or penalties, but something called liquidated damages, the cost of the loss Emerson may have caused the car park owner in that 25 seconds. So is $95 fair?
I would say that there's probably more on the unreasonable side. What has it cost them to enforce it? What is the loss that's been suffered? If you feel that the charge is unreasonable, given the circumstances of the length of time that you were there, and the harm suffered, the cost of enforcing, you do have the ability to dispute that charge.
And on stronger grounds, if the sign isn't clear or if terms aren't there in full to read before you park. In this case, it doesn't mention 21 days to pay and $75 weekly reminders, just that there's more detail online.
I'm not sure that actually having a link to a website is providing enough information. For example, my mother doesn't use a cell phone and wouldn't be able to log on and check what those additional terms are.
If you don't have internet to get the full terms and conditions, then maybe you shouldn't park there.
This is the man behind that sign. Jake Thomas is fighting a one-man war on people just nipping in for a minute while using someone else's park.
This is creating a huge cost for business owners and private owners of these car parks. I got sick of it, so this is why I started parking services.
He sends out the signs and the businesses send back proof.
Basically, they send us photographic evidence. Through on the photos comes metadata, the time of the shot, it comes GPS location, all the information that we need to put onto a breach notice, and then we send that out to the person that parked there and enforce it.
Like Emerson and his $340 Coke Zero.
There's a lot of confusion there. Emerson's English isn't very good. We have got to the bottom of that. He was overcharged $95 in the end, and we have returned that to him.
Which is still $245 in fees, all to parking services, including two $75 reminders.
Why do you think those charges are reasonable?
There's not a huge huge volume of tickets that come out of these car parks. There's a lot of costs in signage. There's also a lot of other costs that we have to endure. And on top, we need to make a profit. Like if my company doesn't profit, then we're not going to be here to do it.
Part of doing business well is getting it right. So why the silence when Emerson tried to appeal?
Yeah, so we could have done better in that situation. I do think that his lack of good English helped the situation at all.
Emerson felt he had to pay.
Yeah, I have no option right now.
But he could have spent $45 to take this to the disputes tribunal to ask it to decide whether he actually owed that much.
We're happy for the challenge.
Though it will probably be a lot harder to argue that now Emerson has paid up.
It's a very expensive drink.
Yeah, very expensive drink.
I may appear calm, but I am so mad. I'm writing a letter to the editor and I'm ringing TalkBack.
Yeah,
it's ridiculous.
It is. But the moral of the story is be careful where you park. But if you feel the charges are unfair, dispute them in writing and take it to the disputes tribunal if you can't work it out.